Este es el discurso completo en donde Trump habla con transparencia sobre la administración Biden. Mis patriotas, mírenlo antes que bloqueen esta información. Y que viva Trump presidente 2024. Much.
Thank you very much. Great crowd. This is beautiful. I want to thank Michael and congratulations on your re-election as party chairman. That's a big deal. That was a big deal. It's great to be back in North Carolina, a very special place, very, very special place. We've had tremendous success here. We won it twice. We won the primaries twice. We won the election twice. It was great. Sit down. Come on, let's whoopee with each other. We have nothing else to do tonight. I also want to thank our outstanding NRCC chair. Chairman, where is the chairman? Richard Hudson, where's the chairman? Come on, Richard, stand up. We just got back from Georgia, and he's even a celebrity in Georgia. We had a great crowd in Georgia, too. He's fourth in line for speaker, and his wonderful wife, Renee, is incredible. And she served 4 years, actually, in the White House as Kellyanne. Is anyone here of Kellyanne Conway? Nobody, right? She's so fantastic, but thank you. And thank the family. The family is fantastic. We appreciate it. Thanks also to one of the great stars of the party, one of the great stars in politics, Lieutenant Governor Mark Robinson. And I'm going to endorse Mark, but I'm not going to tell you about it tonight, okay? We'll save it for another time. But you can count on it, Mark. Congratulations. Great job. You've been doing a fantastic job. We also have some warriors that we fight together with all the time, and we win a lot. We win most of the time. Representatives Dan Bishop. Where's Dan? Dan. Thank you, Dan. Thank you, Dan. Thank you very much. Great job. Great job. We love him. Chuck Edwards. Chuck. Chuck. Thank you, Chuck. Thank you. Thank you very much. And State House Speaker Tim Moore. Tim, thank you very much. Great job. Tim is doing a fantastic job. Thank you. For 7 years, we've been engaged in an epic struggle to rescue our country from the sinister forces who actually hate it and want to destroy it. I really believe they want to destroy it. There can be no other reason. These forces are far stronger than Russia, China, North Korea, and Iran all put together, because with the right leader, you saw that just 3 years ago, we have the right leader. All of those countries are absolutely no threat. They're not any threat to us. We talked about it before. Right now, however, they're putting us in the most dangerous position in the history of our country. We've never been in a position like this. There's never been such danger. It's because of the weaponry, the power of the weaponry. And we have people that have no clue, the people in office that have no clue. Together, we stand up to the globalists. We stand up to the Marxists. We stand up to the rhinos, because they're very bad. Because you don't know where they're coming from, the rhinos, you don't know where they're coming from. We stand up to the communists and the environmental extremists, because I'm an environmentalist. I really believe that. We've done some great things for the environment, but you have extremists, and you don't know whether or not they're really serious about some of this stuff. It's not even believable. We stand up to the open borders fanatics destroying our country. The radical left Democrats, their lawless partisan prosecutors, and the fake news media. We have a lot of it back there, but not all of them are fake. That's a big group back there, by the way. Dan, I think they're here for you, maybe. And on November 5th, 2024, we're going to stand up to the corrupt political establishment. We're going to evict a totally corrupt president named Joe Biden from the White House. And we're going to finish The job that we so successfully started, probably there's been no more important 4 years than we had. We did a great job, all of us together. Things we did, nobody thought were possible. I put everything on the line. I will never yield. I will never be deterred. I will never stop fighting for you. Never. And if I wasn't leading in the polls by so much, we'd have no difficulty. And you know, they're the party of disinformation. They say, oh, we want to run against Trump. In the meantime, we got 5,000 prosecutors after us because they don't want to run against Trump. We beat him the first time. We did much better the second time. We beat him. We did much better the second time. More than any other president, more votes than any other sitting president has ever gotten, and more votes in terms of the margin, from 63 million, and he had millions and millions. No president's done that. Usually they get less the second time. You know, you get tired of them. They weren't tired of me because we got many more votes. With your vote, we will take back our country from these fascists and thugs, and we will indeed make America great again. From the beginning, our America First agenda has been an existential threat to the rotten political class that gets rich and powerful at your expense. Erasing our borders, cheating like we've never seen before in elections, exporting our jobs and squandering our blood and treasure on endless foreign wars. We didn't start any wars first time in 71 years. No wars. They all said, Trump will get us into a war. He's got that personality. No, it was my personality that kept us out of wars. But we finished some wars. We finished ISIS, 100% of the caliphate. We knocked out ISIS. We did whatever we had to do. And we were respected all over the world as warriors without having to fight wars. You know who doesn't fight too many wars? China. You ever notice? It's all talk. It's beautiful military. They try and beat you economically, not militarily. And there's something very smart about that, isn't there? But they respected us. They respected your president and they respected our country. They no longer respect us. And it's very sad what's happening. They've launched one hoax. These people we have to deal with, and they've launched witch hunt after witch hunt, and they just tried to stop our movement. They want to do anything they can to thwart the will of the American people. It's called election interference. That's what they're doing now. This is election interference. And we've never seen it on a scale like this. And you have to understand, the other side is downright crooked. That's why we now call him Crooked Joe Biden, because, you know, we took the name away from Hillary. She suffered enough with that name. So I retired the name from Hillary because I wanted to bring it over to Biden, because he's probably worse than she ever was, and that's saying something. As the Durham report proved, they spied on my campaign. They forged false evidence to get illegal surveillance warrants. The FBI offered $1 million for a fictitious dossier written by a foreign spy to try and frame me for treason. We beat it all off, didn't we? They put our country through hell, and they knew it was a lie the entire time. They knew it was a lie. They knew the laptop from hell was a lie. They knew everything. Remember, it's not me they're going to go after. And if you think of it, whoever took my place, and I hope it's not going to be anybody, because we're the ones that are going to save this country, because our country's in trouble. They'll go after that person, and that person will not be able to withstand the fire. And I know all of them. I know them all. And they actually admit it. They come to me, how do you stand this? And I usually look at them and say, in a sick way, I sort of enjoy it. Because it exposes them. It exposes them for what they are, and it's also lifted the poll numbers to even higher legs. Have you seen this? The polls are through the roof, and the fundraising, small dollar fundraising, is setting records. But still, you get indicted over nothing. You get indicted over the Presidential Records Act, which they don't even admit they call it the Espionage Act. These are sick people. We had Russia, Russia, Russia. Ukraine, Ukraine, Ukraine. The no collusion Mueller witch hunt. Impeachment hoax number one. Remember the perfect phone call? Impeachment hoax number two. The illegal censorship of the Hunter Biden laptop from hell. The 51 intelligence officials who falsely said it was Russian disinformation. Remember they said that? I said nobody.
Pictures, horrible pictures. The real pictures
haven't been exposed yet. But all of this, and it just kept coming and coming and coming, and it would for another person in my position, but they wouldn't be able to handle it. They wouldn't be able to take it because you're dealing with crazy lunatics. Now the Marxist left is once again using the same corrupt DOJ and the same corrupt FBI and attorneys general and local district attorneys to interfere in our election at a level that our country has never witnessed before. These criminals cannot be rewarded. They must be defeated. We have to defeat them soundly. In the end, they're not coming after me. They're coming after you, and I'm just standing in their way. The baseless indictment of me by the Biden administration's weaponized Department of Injustice will go down as among the most horrific abuses of power in the history of our country. I think it already is, when you think about it. And certainly going back to Obama, when I said, you know, they spied on my campaign, everybody, including the fake news media back there, they said, oh, that's so crazy. Turned out I was right. This vicious persecution is a travesty of justice. You're watching Joe Biden try to jail his leading political opponent. Think of it. This is like third world country stuff. Trying to put his opponent, who's leading him by a lot, wants to put him in jail over following a civil act. This is a simple thing. The Presidential Records Act, it's all under the Presidential Records Act, as it should be. It's all under the Clinton Sox case. You know what this Clinton Sox case is? That's where they sued Clinton and he ended up winning, that he could keep the things that we're talking about. It's all under that, Mr. Congressman. We discussed that before. But this is more like Stalinist Russia or Communist China that we're dealing with. These people have reached a level of Trump derangement syndrome that nobody thought was possible. And I never thought, frankly, that this could happen in America. You go after a president that got, again, the most votes by far of any sitting president in history, gets out of office. And because I'm running, if I wasn't running, wouldn't even be talking about it. If I weren't leading, we wouldn't be talking about it. But we're leading by a lot. We are leading to sanctimonious by massive numbers. He's heading south quickly. No personality. You got to have a personality to win. He's got no personality. And, you know, remember that when he came to me, he had virtually no votes. He was dying, as the expression goes. He was dead. I said, George Washington could endorse you. It wouldn't matter. No, sir, if you endorse me, I'm telling you I'm going to win. I said, let's give it a shot. I endorsed him. He went up like a rocket ship, and shortly thereafter, they had the primary, and he won. And then we had to get him through a crackhead. But nobody knew he was a crackhead at the time. At the time, he was the hottest politician in the Democrat Party, male version. Female version, Stacey Abrams. True. Stacey Abrams and him. But he was hard to beat, and Ron said to me, I don't think I can beat him. I said, you beat him, you beat him. And I did three rallies, massive, massive, massive rallies, thousands and thousands of people. And I said, you're going to win. And he ended up winning. And then they started cheating at the end. You remember all the votes were disappearing over days, 10,000 here,
Rick Scott, same thing. And I called in, you wouldn't believe it, the FBI. Would you believe it? And it stopped. So at least they did something right. But I got him in. And then they said to him, I said, congratulations, Ron. I didn't know him that well. He was one of the many people that supported me during the impeachment hoaxes. So I'd see him on television a little bit, but I didn't know him well. Then I heard 3 years later, they said, would you run against the president? And he said, I have no comment. That means he's gonna run. I said, I got this guy in, Mr. Congressman. And he said he's going to run. And then I haven't been very nice to him since then. But we're leading in Florida by 28 points, and people are not happy with him, and he's a lousy campaigner. Remember that when he came to see me, he had almost no points. He was ready to look for a new career. You told me that better than anybody. He was looking for a job. And when I endorsed him, it was like magic. It was like he was a rocket ship. But I believe in loyalty. And, you know, it's just very disloyal. If somebody got me into office, and I got him in. You know, some people I help. Some people I help, and some people I get. And I got this guy in, along with some others. But some people I help, and that's different. Some people I help a little bit, some people I help a lot, but some people I get in. I got this guy in. So, you know, you'd think there'd be a little bit of a loyalty. And it's bad for the Republican Party, frankly, but let's see what happens. We're leading by a lot, but meanwhile, Joe Biden had troves and troves, thousands of boxes, classified documents from his time as vice president and even as a senator. And boy, when you're a senator and you take classified documents, that's a big deal. I watched Dick Durbin get so angry about it, I said, well, he'll be brought back into the fold eventually. But he went out, and Senator Durbin, he said, you can't, as a senator, take classified documents out of a skiff. He took them out of a skiff. As a senator, it's unheard of. I spoke to a lot of senators. They said, I don't believe it. A lot of them. They didn't believe it. And they come after me. And we had a wonderful operation. Everything by the Presidential Records Act. We were talking to NARA. But, you know, NARA's radical left. You know, they have a red flag on the Constitution of the United States and on the Bill of Rights. You know what red flag is? It is a dangerous document. This is where NARA is coming from. And they're very, really, they've done, I would say over the last number of years, very poor job. But they're very, very radical left. So you have to be careful of these people. But they conspire with the FBI, they conspire with, it's just a crazy situation, I mean, that this country goes through. If we could devote the same brilliance to making America great.